Shalom, giving all glorification, honor, and praise unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rekah HaKadosh. Double honors to the venerable apostles of the great millstone, along with the bishops and elders who are ruling and teaching the church well in these last days. And salutations to the Bayashah Dawadad, is the house of David, the elect. I'm Shamar Moth here with a quick article. Today is Thursday, November the 16th, 2023. The hopeful year that all these prophecies come to pass. And this is off the Irish Star. And the headline reads, nuclear war in the U.S. would wipe out 300 million people from radiation, experts claim. And actually, the nuclear destruction that's coming to this place in the form of the intercontinental ballistic missiles and the chariots of the Lord is going to wipe out everyone. Okay. Everyone who remains. Okay. In this country, so-called country, who makes it through Jacob's troubles like you, is going to perish as a result of this nuclear fire that's coming. Hold on. Let me get a preset real quick. This is, let's see. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 49, and verse 17. Also, Edom shall be a desolation. Everyone that goeth by it shall be astonished and shall hiss at all the plagues thereof. As in the overthrow of Sodom and Gomorrah, verse 18, and the neighbor cities thereof, saith the Lord, Yahweh Bahashem Yahushua, no man shall abide there, neither shall the son of man dwell in it. So, again, Edom, all right, the so-called white man over here in America is going to be destroyed. All right, it talks about the third part of men being destroyed as a result of this nuclear destruction. All right, the third part of men being Esau. And this is Revelation chapter 9 and verse it's like 17. And thus I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them, having breastplates of fire and of jacinth and brimstone, and the heads of the horses were as the heads of lions, talking about the nukes. And out of their mouths issued fire and smoke and brimstone. By these three was the third part of men killed, verse 18. By the fire and by the smoke and by the brimstone which issued out of their mouths. Yeah, so again, you have three classifications of men in the earth. You have the children of the Most High, the sons of God, the sons of the power, all right, the Israelites, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. You have the sons or the children of men, all right, the nations, and then you have the sons or the children of the wicked one, and them is the Edomites. Okay, so this nuclear war that's coming is going to wipe out everyone, all right, outside of the Lord's election, okay? Everyone left, all right, on the shores of Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, again, those who make it through Jacob's trouble are going to perish, okay? They're going to catch nukes, thus saith the scriptures. It says, the vast majority of the U.S. population could potentially be wiped out if there was ever a nuclear attack, according to experts. Well, that nuclear attack is coming, okay? See, you people aren't looking for it, all right? Two-thirds of our people ain't looking for it. Two-thirds of you Israelites ain't looking for this. Y'all ain't even considering this. When the book of Sirach I was reading earlier in chapter 18 and verse 24, it talks about thinking upon the wrath that's to come. Okay, hold on, let me get it. And you're not doing that. Sirach, chapter 18. You're not doing that. All you're concerned with is folly. All right. bullshit. This is Sirach chapter 18 and verse 24. Think upon the wrath that shall be at the end. That's what we're supposed to be thinking about. You know, the wrath that's going to be poured out upon this place. All right, during this time we're in, man, which is, you know, the time of Jacob's trouble, we're in the beginning of sorrows. Okay, wrath's coming. All right. Think upon the wrath that shall be at the end and the time of vengeance when he shall turn away his face. Yeah, because he's going to turn away his face, all right, from 2/3 of his own people. Okay? Those who are in the congregation of the dead, the unbelievers. All right? It says, an estimated 300 million people would be put at risk of radiation exposure over the 4 days after the country was hit by the devastating weapons, which these are the weapons of the Lord's indignation. That's what the scriptures calls them, man. Okay, these are the Lord's. This is part of the Lord's armory, okay? And he's about to open up on you fucking sheeple, man, okay? It says, while any enemy attack would most likely focus on the U.S.'s intercontinental ballistic missile launch facilities or silos in Colorado, Montana, Nebraska, North Dakota, and Wyoming as its primary objective, these, it's like the hypothetical figures were highlighted in special report by Scientific American published on Wednesday concerning the U.S.'s nuclear program. It says, it suggested that a huge 90% of the country's 48 lower states, along with people in Mexico's northern states and the most populated parts of Canada, could suffer from radiation if weather conditions are right or slightly are right or wrong in this case. Yeah, no, everybody's going to be wiped out by this, all right? And you know, the Lord, okay, Yahweh Shai, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, you know, he's going to come back during the midst of World War III, okay, to deliver, again, the elect lamb, starting with the 144,000 in service to prophets, Lord willing, that's us, starting with the elder apostles, the great millstone on down. He's coming back to deliver the 144,000, which is the first fruits of salvation, and that multitude, those among Israel who believe what we're saying, all right, through the Spirit. But yeah, America's going to be completely destroyed, devastated. Ain't nobody going to survive, man. All right, ain't nobody going to survive. I'm going to end up with Malachi. For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. Yeah, World War III. Right? And all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly, Esau, okay, primarily, all right, 2/3, okay, shall be stubble. Yep. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushua of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. That's right. The wicked gonna be rooted out of here, man. Burnt up. All right. So I thought this was interesting and a very spiritual headline. Lord willing, he was edified through the Spirit. And with that, I want to say shalom and on to the next video.